Hey guys, this video is all about how to plant, grow and care for the freesia plants. Today's date is 20 October 2018 and please make sure to watch the full video because at the end of the video you are going to see lots of blooms and this way you are going to learn everything about freesias in a single video. Alright, now these are the 6 bulbs as you can see here and now I am just going to plant them. For the potting mix, I am taking 40% of garden soil, 30% of vermicompost and rest 30% of cocopeat. Instead of cocopeat, you can also use river sand and instead of vermicompost, you can also use compost cow dung powder. And to grow the freesia plants, I am going to use a 6 inches of a plastic pot and you can see that it has lots of drainage holes. So I just kept some broken pieces of the clay pot on the drainage hole so that water can drain out well. So whatever pot you are using, just make sure it has at least one drainage hole and keep something on the drainage hole so that water can drain out well. You can do just like this way. While filling the pot with the potting mix, please press the soil very lightly or even tap down the pot so that air pockets are removed. While planting the bulbs, you might get confused like which way is up and which way is down. It's really very simple actually. The pointed end is up and the flat part is the down. Now I am just going to plant the bulbs and you can follow me and you can also see that I haven't filled my pot completely. And reason is that, see, you should plant the freesia bulbs at least 1.5 to 2 inches deep in the soil and that's the reason why I haven't filled my pot completely. See, I am done and now it's time for watering. Since this is the first time watering, we should water heavily. But while watering for the second time, please make sure that first 1 inches or even 1.5 inches of soil is dry and then only water your pot, otherwise the bulbs might rot. And while filling the pot with the potting mix, please make sure that there is a gap of at least 1 inches in between the top layer of the soil and surrounding the rim, and only that way you'd be able to water your plants properly. So you can see planting is done and now I am going to keep the pot on terrace and there it would be getting lots of sunlight. Now please keep watching and like I said you earlier, I am going to show you lots of blooms at the end of the video. Hey guys, updating the video after 27 days and you can see that all of my freesia bulbs have sprouted. So while growing freesia, please have patience because they need time to sprout. And now please keep watching and I will be showing you at the time of fertilizing. Hey guys, updating the video on day 69 and today's date is 29th of December 2018. So this is how all of my plants look as you can see here. And today I am going to fertilize my plants and that's why I just thought to update the video. There is another thing which I did today as well. I just repotted all of my plants from the previous pot to a bigger pot which is 8 inches of a pot. And I did this thing because in my previous pot my plants were not getting enough water and that's why I was able to find brown edges on the leaves of my plants. So you can just follow me now and I am going to show you fertilizing my plants. For fertilizing, I am going to apply 1 teaspoon of NPK 19-19-19. 1 teaspoon is almost equal to 5 grams and I am going to take same amount of Epsom salt. The fertilizer, whatever I am applying, is 100% water soluble fertilizer and please don't worry, I am also going to give other alternative ways to fertilize your freesias at the end of the video. To fertilize, I am going to apply directly in the soil and you can also see that I have already provided supports to my plants and please provide supports to your freesia plants at this stage and as they would be needing the support. And you can just use bamboo stick and clothes or even some kind of a soft object just to tie them. Alright. Hey guys, updating the video almost after 130 days and today's date is 3rd March 2019. Now this is what I was promising at the beginning and this is the end part of the video and in this part I am going to discuss all the things that I did for my freesia bulbs. Now if you remember, I planted 6 bulbs in one pot and most of the bulbs has produced the flowering watering spikes, and that's why I just thought to end the video. So the first important thing is sunlight. See, you already know that I was keeping all of my pots on terrace, and that's why they were getting the whole day of sunlight. But when I found that they are almost producing the flowering spike, I mean, I am talking about this one, I was protecting them from the midday heat or even the afternoon sunlight. I changed their place and they were getting the morning sunlight till around 11 a.m. The next important thing is proper watering. See, please always take time in between watering and let the topsoil, I would say that at least 1/2 inches of the soil, dry out in between watering. You can see how my soil is looking, as you can see here, and for all of my freesia bulbs I am watering them once in a 2 to 3 days. And you can do this, I mean, keep the soil like this way, whatever you are looking right now, let it dry out and then only water your plants. If the tips of the leaves are turning brown or even edges of the leaves are turning somewhat brown, then most likely you are underwatering your plants. I have a video where I have shown the exact reason of brown tips on the freesia plants, so please do check out that video if you want to know more about that. I will put the link in the description box. So far I have fertilized them only once and I am not going to fertilize them again. The reason is that they are just like lilies and they bloom only once per season. But if you want, you can keep on fertilizing your plants once in a 30 to 40 days just to keep the bulbs healthy for the next season. I have also shown you how I fertilize my plants, but yes, for other 2 pots I apply different kind of fertilizers so that I can give you multiple options of fertilizing your plants. So for this pot, whatever I said that day, I applied NPK for this pot, and for this pot I just applied 70 grams of vermicompost, and for this pot I applied DAP and potash, 6 crystals of DAP and 1/2 teaspoon of potash, and you can see that results are almost identical. So you can just apply any kind of fertilizers, I mean whatever is easy for you, you can just go ahead with the way and fertilize your plants. No matter whatever you apply, I mean NPK, DAP, potash or even the vermicompost, you are going to get the similar kind of result. While talking about pest attack, see, I did not have to use any kind of pesticide on my freesias, but if you are getting any kind of pest attack, you can apply neem oil in a gap of 10 to 15 days. It's really very easy, just take 5 ml of neem oil, 4 ml of white hand wash, mix them into 1 liter of water and then spray your plants. By the way, I have a video where I have shown the best way to apply the neem oil, so please do check out that video to know the complete procedure, and I will put the link in the description box. Okay, now let's talk about the deadheading. See, I honestly don't think deadheading is really important, but you can simply remove the already wilted blooms, as you can see here, and you can do this just to make them look attractive. And once you find that all buds are bloomed, I am talking about all these buds, you can simply cut the spike here. To propagate freesias, you can do it either by the seeds or even by the bulbs, as you have seen it already. Let me also show you how the freesia seed pod look like. As you can see, this is one freesia seed pod, and if you want to propagate by the seeds, then first let it dry out and then only collect the seeds. And if you are growing freesias in containers just like me, then you might want to dig out the bulb so that you can use the container to grow other plants. But before digging out the bulb, let the plant die themselves so that they can store the energy for the next season. However, if you are growing freesias in the ground, then you can just let it manage themselves and they will be growing again at right time. So guys, this is all about how to grow and care for your freesias, and I really hope that you are enjoying the blooms at this time. Honestly saying, it took really many days, I mean 130 days, but I am glad that I am able to show you blooms at the end of the video. So if you have any questions regarding freesias or any other gardening questions, simply write down the comment below and I will get back to you as soon as possible. And at the same time, if you have experience of growing freesias already, please share your experience with us so that many viewers along with myself would be able to learn something new from you. So guys, thank you very much for taking your valuable time to watch the video, and I really hope that you found this video useful. If you did, please do me a favor, please like the video, share the video and subscribe to my channel if you haven't. In case you did not like the video, please let me know by commenting so that I can improve myself. And before leaving, please also do check out the video which I have done on pansy. As you can see, an excellent plan for your garden. Thank you once again, have a great day.